I get a few questions very commonly regarding the implementation of an A/B test. In this video, I want to address four of these. The first one is what I call the change one thing at a time myth, and this is a very common A/B testing misconception. In an A/B test, you can only change one thing at a time. The truth is that you can change more things. Remember my landing page A/B test from module 2? I ran an experiment on one of my course landing pages, and I didn't change only one picture or one headline, I changed the whole page. As you can see, I changed more than one thing. I've added a lot of text, images, and videos. The whole structure of the website changed. Still, I pulled off a 96% conversion increase, so I definitely didn't regret changing more than one thing in this particular experiment. I have to admit something, though. Changing more than one thing is risky. Why? Because whether your conversion rate goes up or down, or it stays the same, you won't know the contribution of the individual elements in that change. Maybe your new images increased the number of registrations, but the new wording decreased it, or maybe it's the other way around, but you won't know that because you will only see the total effect. So it's a risk, sure, but in my opinion, small and medium-sized businesses should take that risk. For huge players like Google, Facebook, Amazon, of course this is different. Let's say that Amazon changes one tiny thing on their website, they move up a button by 30 pixels, and let's say it increases their conversion rate by 0.1%. Since they are a huge business, first, they have many, many users, so they will still have enough data points to evaluate that 0.1% conversion increase as statistically significant. And also, at their revenue size, the absolute value of the small 0.1% relative change can still be huge. For instance, it can cover the salary of 100 or even 1,000 new employees. But smaller businesses are in a different position. For them, the absolute value of a relative 0.1% change is hardly noticeable, and also very importantly, smaller businesses have a smaller audience size, so a change as small as moving a button with 30 pixels would never bring in a big enough sample size to consider the results statistically significant. So practically, they can't even run an experiment like that. The point is, yes, big players with hundreds of millions of users should change one thing at a time in their experiments, but smaller businesses have to take greater risks and aim for greater results. And one more thing about this whole change one thing at a time myth, although this might lead to philosophical depths, but what is one thing at all? Is it one picture, one color, one headline, or one pixel, or one block of your web page, or a whole section of your web page, or a whole landing page? Well, you decide, but I recommend following this concept. Big businesses should A/B test individual elements, like pixels, button text, button placements, and so on, but small and medium-sized businesses should A/B test concepts, like a whole landing page, site-wide messaging, site-wide design, and so on. The next typical question is this. Should I use multivariate testing? If you don't know what multivariate testing is, here is a simple example. You want to experiment with two things on your website, your headline and your button color. You want to know the contribution of both individual elements in your results, so the best way to get that information is to set up all possible combinations. Like so, original, changing the button color only, changing the headline only, and changing both the button color and the headline. This means four variations in your A/B test. While in theory, this works, I only recommend multivariate testing for bigger online businesses and only when you are more advanced with A/B testing. Obviously, running four versions in an A/B test will take a bigger audience size to get statistically significant results. If you don't have that big of an audience, it's a much simpler approach to test first your original version against your red button version, for instance. And when you have concluded that test, then starting a new experiment where you can test your new headline against the previous experiment's winner. It's not just simpler, but quite often it's also faster than a multivariate test. And honestly, I see too many junior data people get confused when analyzing their multivariate test results. So my advice here, keep it simple, and for now, don't use multivariate tests. The third typical question I get, can I run an ABCD test? It's similar to the multivariate test question, but in an ABCD test, you don't necessarily combine the elements you test. For example, you can simply test 5 different headlines against each other. Regardless, the issue is the same. If you don't have a big enough audience, you will have to wait longer to get statistically significant results. So can you run an A-B test with more than 2 versions? The answer is easy. In the statistics module, we saw how to calculate the required sample size per variations. From that, you can easily figure out how many variations you can run next to each other. If you have a big enough audience, feel free not only run an A-B test, but even an A, B, C, D, E, and so on test. And the last question is, can I use a less usual, for example, a 30-70 audience split? The answer is yes, but only to favor your original version. When you run A-B tests, you want to be really careful. You run your tests because you want to make sure that your new version is indeed better than your old version. So it's okay to be more careful and show your new version only for a smaller percent of your audience, but I wouldn't recommend doing it the other way around. Also, the real question here, again, is whether you have a big enough audience. For instance, for one of my clients where we had millions of users per month for their product, usually we A/B tested our new designs and features with only 2% of the audience, and we still got statistically significant results quite fast. At the same time, because the new feature was safely tested with a tiny part of the audience, when we had a losing A/B test, it didn't really have a negative impact on the overall results of the whole business. And when we had winning ones, we scaled up the new version to a more usual 50-50 split to rerun the experiment with a bigger sample size. And if it was positive too, we released the new version to 100%. Okay, these were 4 typical questions about the implementation of an A/B test, and I hope that this helped you to demystify a few commonly mentioned concepts regarding experiments.